was just an ordinary day. My sister was coming up for dinner and been in the house myself with the kids. I asked them if they could help me tidy up. So we went into the bedroom and started tidying up the balls into the ball pit. And I then left that room and went into the living room to pick another pieces up while they finished off tidying up what was in the bedroom. It was only a couple of minutes I'd left the room for when my son Lewis came into the living room and asked for a drink, which prompted me to think maybe Ailey wants a drink as well, and that's when I walked through to the room. I found Ailey not hanging at the window. She was just hands down by her side, looking very sad from behind. It wasn't until I walked right up to her and I could see her ear was blue and I could hear the gasping. I realised that the cord from the blind at the window was strangling her and she was unable to breathe. I quickly released the cord and grabbed her and ran to the living room and dialed 999.
The paramedic arrived within minutes. Ailey had stopped breathing and was unconscious. Although he managed to start her breathing again, it wasn't till next day in the hospital that she regained consciousness. Ailey was unbelievably lucky and has since made a full recovery. We have records on the numbers of children who have died through being strangled by a blind cord, but little information on those who have survived but may have suffered brain damage through lack of oxygen. Blinds and blind cords are commonplace in our homes. No one thinks twice about them. They're just part of the furniture and they don't get a second look. Many parents and grandparents are completely unaware of the dangers posed by looped blind cords. Most of the children are under 5. Many are toddlers who are just finding their way about and interested in everything they can reach. Once entangled, the child can choke very quickly and the carer may be completely unaware of what's happening because the child can't shout for help.
I take my child's safety very seriously. I have baby gates up, I have plugs in the sockets, but I was not aware of these cords and how dangerous they can be. Once we go over the shock, we realised how many other parents might not be aware of the dangers.
Since the accident, Debbie has worked tirelessly to raise awareness amongst parents, carers and nurseries. She's been interviewed by local papers and has started a Facebook campaign.
No parent can watch their child 24/7, and this only took a couple of minutes to happen, but a couple minutes more could have been a total tragedy.
Cleats are small devices that are easily fitted. This should be a height safely out of the reach of children. The blind cord is then wrapped round the cleat, not left hanging down, where children could be tempted to play with it. As Debbie says, you can't be with your child every minute of the day, so taking the time to install cleats where they live, play, visit friends and family will protect them from the dangers of looped blind cords.